You're listening to the audio production of Find Your People, Audio Bible Studies, by Jennie Allen, published by Zondervan and presented by the author. These audio studies are a unique learning experience. Unlike a traditional audiobook's direct narration of a book's text, Find Your People includes high-quality live recordings that cover the important points from each chapter, as well as relevant material from other sources.
So I want to tell you the number one question that I hear from you. You ready? How do I make friends? It is this universal thing, and yet it's this simple thing. But apparently it feels complicated. How do I find my people? Way back in 2019, before everything changed, I started a podcast to bring people together, ideas together, to teach, to disciple. And what was the very first thing we tackled? The very first thing that was pressing, that we saw we had to talk about? Friendship, or your lack of it. Everyone feels this. Everyone feels this sometimes. I get this question from young people, from old people, people in the middle, single, married, in big families, or small families. People you would think that had a handle on this. People you would never describe as lonely. Why? Is this just some human condition? Does it have to be this way? We all feel isolated right now. Independent. I rarely meet people who somewhere, somehow don't feel just a little bit lonely. We smile, we nod, we shelter in our places, and honestly, it's killing us slowly, quietly. And we've lost deep, safe connections that God built us for. So, I think this comes at the perfect time. It's time for us to actually look underneath the question of what makes us lonely and why are we lonely, and to figure it out and to get free of it. Without true, deep, connected friendship and community, life feels so empty. We are not built to do life alone. Our world has been deep in this epidemic of loneliness, and it's been like this for a long time. In fact, research tells us 3 in 5 people feel lonely, and that number is just rising. So no longer, unlike most of the generations before us, do we live in a village context, a tight-knit community that everything centers around. Deep, authentic community isn't set up for us anymore to just naturally walk out the front door and to have people living and doing life right in front of us. And even if somehow it does, people still hurt us. They still let us down. And so we tuck into our little residences with our little family, our roommate, or maybe we're alone and we stare at our little screens and we make dinner for just us. And we never want to trouble our neighbors for anything, so we Amazon it. And we build a small little crevice in the world with everything that we could possibly need. We keep our doors locked and we feel safe. But in building our little world, we are completely cut off from the people outside of it. And we may feel comfortable and safe and independent and even entertained. But honestly, most of us are completely sad. See, there is a reason this is all so messy, so difficult. Because we are going to talk about here, there is an enemy who loves for us to feel alone. So we're going to brave this subject, and we're gonna look at it because God wants freedom for us. He wants thriving for us. And we're gonna unstick from this place where we could stay and we could feel safe and we could hide, because God tells us in Genesis, He makes a human and He says, it is not good for man to be alone. And you know that's true in your soul. I wanna say to you who truly feels alone, that showed up here with just this much hope that maybe things could change. Things can change. There is a hope and a vision and an outline for change in this book. God has a plan for us to connect deeply. And he knows that you need this. He knows that we need this. And he knows that we tend to hide and pull away from this. So if you stick with me, if you go through these 7 weeks honestly and openly, at the end of this, your relationships are going to look different than they did before. You will look different. And I believe you will have friends. I know, big promise. You're also gonna find out, though, that generations upon generations before us have been fighting the same things that we're fighting. People separated, divided, shame, jealousy, mistrust. Paul fought those things throughout the New Testament. Adam and Eve fought them in the garden, and it continued on and over until us. So let me tell you my hopes for us here. I want us to trade lonely and isolated lives that experience brief bursts of connectedness for intimately connected lives that know only brief bursts of feeling alone. What would that even look like for you? We're gonna find out. I know it's a crazy, audacious hope, but this is what we were built for. This family, this village, this sisterhood, it's available to us. Even if it feels impossible to you right now, we can build it. God gave us a roadmap to build it. And we have to try. So we're gonna do a crash course that I took personally from this book and from looking back at generations of how people have lived in this world, why loneliness wasn't such a big deal just a few generations ago. And this crash course I took when we moved from Austin to Dallas, Texas, and we had to start over just about from scratch. And I know it just sounds like it was a few hours away, but man, it may as well have been in the other side of the world because I had to start over. We all had to start over. I showed up with my husband and my 4 kids, and every one of us had to make friends from scratch. And we moved here, and we got deeply involved in a community and a family. And here's the thing. I didn't know where to turn for help when I got here. I didn't have anything to do on a Saturday night. How do you build a life out of nothing? And the ache of craving that and knowing that I need it, it's so recent and fresh for me. And honestly, if I hadn't been put in that position where I had to get really intentional and even awkward about making some real friends really fast, I think I might have not had a clue how to do this. But he brought me back to these simple practices, the ways we make friends. So let's go back to the beginning of this book. How did it start? You ready? Genesis 1, in the beginning, God. First, God existed in community with himself, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. And he created us out of his love, a community of three growing and multiplying. Genesis 2:18 says that after God had created one person on the earth, Adam, he said, "It is not good for man to be alone." That is the truth that you and I still know, you and I still feel in our bones. So we know that from the beginning of creation in this book, the very first observation God makes about a person is that it is not good for that person to be alone. So God creates a family. He creates Eve, and together that first couple have children. And the first community God sets into motion is a family. It is by God's design, a good design. In fact, family was God's first and best place for us to have community. But we know it would break down. Adam and Eve, though, would be fruitful and they would multiply on the earth, and there would be people all over the earth who knew God and loved God and who worshiped God. That was the plan. God gave Adam and Eve everything they needed in order to thrive, to grow, to live together on this earth. At creation, Adam and Eve lived together with God in the garden. They were naked and unashamed, no shame. Before each other, and no shame before God. Free, beautiful, safe, authentic relationship. And they shared the goal of caring for creation. They had a mission. But what does all of this have to do with you and me and our relationships and our longing for deep connection? Let's keep going. In the creation account, heaven on earth actually happened. Yeah, it was brief because sin entered, and it was only between two people, and it was beautiful. And it absolutely happened. And if we have eyes to see the dynamics that were at work in that moment, in the moment before the fall, before sin came, before everything broke down, before the division and the sadness and the hurt, then maybe we could replicate some of those things in our own lives. And when I slow down and really consider what made heaven come to earth, what did that look like back in the Garden of Eden? I see five realities that were there, five tastes of heaven on earth that show us what real community is made of. Number one, proximity. They were living together in connection, day in, day out, breath in, breath out, God with them. And they were together. Transparency, number two. The Bible says that they were naked and unashamed. They were safe, they were known, and they were loved. Accountable. They were accountable to each other. They were accountable to God. Scripture says, bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. And to God, by following his boundaries and not eating of that one tree that he said, do not eat of, there would be connection and there would be accountability and a shared mission. They had a purpose, a beautiful purpose that they lived out together. They took care of the garden and they took care of the animals. They named them and they were faithful to be fruitful and to multiply. And then fifth, there was consistency. They had all the time in the world because death hadn't come into the picture yet. Time to watch things grow and mature and be together and time to enjoy. Proximity, transparency, accountability, mission, and consistency. They made a little bit of heaven on earth. And then I want to show you that these same things, they work now. In fact, most of the relationships that you've enjoyed in your life, you can look back and see most of those things probably present. Most of those tastes of heaven were present in the healthiest relationships that you had. And they provide a framework for how we build healthy community in our own lives. And during these 7 weeks, we're gonna look at the way God established a perfect community so that we can actually reclaim here and now what it looks like to taste a little bit of heaven on earth.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.